Okay, tip number one. It's hard. Get over it. Engineering is tough because it requires a very specific mindset, and that is a technical mindset. I'm sure I recognize our friend in the back who's been in the Robocon lab, right? You've solved a lot of problems and you need that kind of specific mindset to solve those problems. But in engineering, so you need a logical mindset in order to build mathematical models of pieces of technology. And that, for the most part, is what our lecturers, our esteemed lecturers, want you to do in class and what they want you to present in the final exam. To just come up with models of this piece of technology, a rectifier or a diode, and then do the math and just tell a story about that thing. And that's very hard because it's a very logical thing to do, and you need a logical mindset to do it. That's why engineering is a very masculine field of study. You don't find a lot of females in engineering because females tend to gravitate towards the more emotional side of things. If you ask a lot of females what they want to do in college, they most likely answer psychology. But engineering, logical mindset, very masculine thing to do. That's why a lot of guys do it. Right. And because it's logical, the logic behind it is you gotta put in the time, you have to put in the effort to get it done. There's no shortcuts behind that. Of course, I'm repeating the generic stuff that our friends said just now. And so it's hard, get over it. Once you rationalize this, you'll find it easier to move forward. Okay, study tip. This is perhaps one of the most important things that I have practiced over the last 4 years. I used to have, you know, the racetrack, the racing horse give you those free calendars, right? Whenever there's an exam or something important in academics coming around the corner, I would mark down on the calendar when that thing is. I would count back 7 days to before that, and I would always start to open slide 7 days or 1 week before that thing happens. And I think this is a very simple tip designed to help you to keep your head above water and make sure that your studying is effective. Prep 1 week in advance. This is what I've been doing ever since the 2.89 event, especially during my third semester when I took Meds 2. Simple tip, but it's very effective. Success tip. When in doubt, pester the lecturer. Of course, some of us might be very shy. You know, we are kids, and you see these people with master's degrees, PhDs, and you think, you know, oh, I am not worthy. But don't worry, lecturers are people too, sometimes. But you should take advantage of that. One thing that I practice when I really want to score well and do good is that during study week, or the week right before the exam, you go see the lecturer anyway, even if you don't have anything intelligent to say, because for the most part, I didn't have anything intelligent to say. I would just write down a bunch of things from the slide, you know, write it back down. Of course, I've been doing studying and then for the finals, but that week before, go see the lecturer, have a conversation, do some face-to-face time, because you might find yourself suitable to as you learn more from getting face-to-face time. I did this for digital signal processing and analog communications during my second year, and I did well for those subjects. Got a B for DSP and an A for analog comm. Yay. I still remember the person teaching it was Mr. Fu Yi Lu, and the week before that, I just went up to him, wrote down a bunch of my notes, and just had a conversation about the stuff. I mean, I wasn't the smartest person in the world, exactly. Going back to our first point, the logical mindset thing. You don't have to be the smartest person in the world. Every human being is capable of at least using some sort of logical mental capacity. But at the end of the day, as long as you put in the time, that's all that matters. So this tip, if you really want to go hardcore, you should see the lecture 1 week before the final exams. The Malays have this word, minta berkat, or kind of like ask for the blessings of your lecturers, and that's what I do 1 week in advance before the final exam. So it's kind of a habit. So the next tip, you guys have heard this before, study sustained release. The most effective